हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, प्यारे बच्चों, आज हम क्लास टेंथ के लिए केमिस्ट्री पोर्शन स्टार्ट करने जा रहे हैं और वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट यूनिट ऑफ सीबीएसई क्लास टेंथ केमिस्ट्री. द नेम ऑफ द यूनिट इज केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड केमिकल इक्वेशंस. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इफ यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द टॉपिक वेरी वेल, यू मस्ट नो in the unit that there is a concept physical change. What is a physical change? What is a physical change? And what is a chemical change? In case of the unit chemical reactions and equations, you must know these very two concepts. Physical change kisse kehte hai? Chemical change kisse kehte hai? My dear students, a change in which no new substance is formed. No new substance is formed. वो change जहां पे कोई दूसरा नया substance नहीं बन पाएगा उसे कहते हैं फिजिकल चेंज. फॉर एग्जाम्पल डियर स्टूडेंट्स, मेल्टिंग ऑफ आइस. आप लोगों ने कहीं पे सुना होगा आइस इज सॉलिड वाटर. इट इज सॉलिड H2O. माइंड इट, सॉलिड H2O, इट इज आइस. माइंड इट डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अगर हम आइस को हीट कर लेंगे, इफ वी विल प्रोवाइड हीट टू आइस, देख लीजिए डियर स्टूडेंट्स, देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लिक्विड वाटर. देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लिक्विड वाटर. अगर हम सॉलिड मतलब आइस को हीट कर लेंगे, देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लिक्विड वाटर. व्हाट इज इट इज मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला. द मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला ऑफ आइस इज H2O. व्हाट इज द मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला ऑफ लिक्विड वाटर. इट विल बी H2O. यहां पे देख लीजिए डियर स्टूडेंट्स, फर्दर वी विल प्रोवाइड द हीट एंड देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ वाटर वेपर्स. देयर मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला इज ऑल्सो H2O. यहां पे आप देख लीजिए, पहले हमारे पास आइस था, आइस को हमने हीट प्रोवाइड की, देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लिक्विड वाटर. यहां पे भी मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला H2O, यहां पे भी मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला H2O. जब हमने लिक्विड वाटर को हीट प्रोवाइड की, वहां पे देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ वाटर वेपर्स एंड देयर मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला इज H2O. तीनों केसेस में कोई नया सबस्टेंस की, किसी नए सबस्टेंस की फॉर्मेशन नहीं हो जाती है. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज ए फिजिकल चेंज. मेल्टिंग ऑफ आइस और व्हाट वी कैन से इवापोरेशन ऑफ वाटर. दिस इज लिक्विड वाटर इनटू वाटर वेपर्स. आर द रिवर्स प्रोसेस, द कन्वर्जन ऑफ वाटर वेपर्स बैक इनटू वाटर. सेम इट इज ऑल्सो द कंडेंसेशन. व्हाट वी कैन से दीज आर the physical changes, a change in which no new substance is formed. कोई नया substance की, किसी नए substance की formation नहीं हो जाती है, उसी को कहते हैं हम physical change. उसी को हम कहते हैं physical, जब कोई नया substance reaction में नहीं बन पाएगा. Now, a chemical change. What is a chemical change? Chemical change, a change or a process in which new substance is formed. For example, dear students, famous reaction when carbon reacts with oxygen, there is the formation of carbon monoxide. It is two times. solid carbon reacts with gaseous carbon and there is the formation of carbon monoxide which is a gas, which is a gas. Dekh lijiye my dear students, chemical change kisse kehte hain. Yahan pe carbon tha ek element, solid in nature hai, oxygen, gaseous in nature hai, which is present in our atmosphere. There is the formation of a gas when carbon reacts with oxygen. There is the formation of a poisonous gas, carbon monoxide. Dusra substance, ek substance ki formation ho gayi. Lekin dear students, the properties of this very substance is different from carbon and that from oxygen. Iski property is different hai as compared to carbon and oxygen. Yahan pe ek new substance ki formation ho gayi. Ek new substance ki formation ho gayi. That is why we are saying that it is a chemical change. A chemical change is a change in which there is the formation of a new substance with different properties. The properties of carbon monoxide, it is a poisonous gas, while as oxygen is not a poisonous gas. In case of carbon, the properties of carbon is different from that of carbon monoxide. The properties of oxygen different from that of carbon monoxide. Now, a chemical change mein ek naye substance ki formation ho jati hai. Mind it, these are the original substances. Original substances. Original substances. In case of, or in other words, we can say in case of a chemical change, the original substance loses its nature as well as identity. Iski identity, uska nature, ye solid in nature tha. Now, oxygen, gaseous in nature, there is the formation of a new substance which is gaseous in nature, but that is carbon monoxide. Iski property is different hai as compared to carbon and oxygen. Means, in case of a chemical change, it is a process in which a new substance is formed. Simple terms mein aap na likh sakte ho. Ya, in case of a chemical change, original substances lose their nature and identity and form new substances with different properties. With different properties. Or koi bhi aap reaction or le sakte ho. For example, N2 combines with 3H2. And there is the formation of NH3 two times. Nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas and there is the formation of ammonia gas. New substance ki formation ho jati hai. This is a chemical change. This is a chemical change. Now, dear students, what is a chemical reaction? What is a chemical reaction? Chemical reaction, those reactions, those processes which involve a chemical change. Yahan pe main likhunga. Chemical reaction किसे कहते हैं? Before आप लोगों को अगर chemical reaction की definition अच्छी तरह से आप लोगों को समझनी है, तो आप लोगों को पता होना चाहिए कि physical change क्या होती है और chemical change क्या होती है. मैं यहाँ पे लिखूँगा a process in which new substances. With different properties are formed. A process which involves a chemical change, which involves a chemical change. Wo process jahan pe ek chemical change ho jayegi. Ab aap logon ko samajh aa gaya hoga ki chemical change kisse kehte hain. Chemical change wo process hoti hai jahan pe ek new substance ki formation ho jati hai aur us new substance ki jo properties hongi wo different hongi from that of the original substance. Yahi chemical reaction ki bhi definition hai. A process in which new substances with different properties are formed are a process which involves a chemical change. For example, यही वही example जो मैंने chemical change में दे दी. Carbon plus oxygen gives carbon monoxide. Gives carbon monoxide. Or in other words, we will say carbon plus oxygen. They will also give. There is also the formation of carbon dioxide. Are you getting my point? For example, I am saying that यहाँ पे carbon एक atom और oxygen दो. There is the formation of carbon dioxide. Or two times carbon plus O2. Then there is the formation of 2 times CO. This is carbon dioxide. This is carbon monoxide. When one carbon atom reacts with oxygen, one oxygen molecule, there is the formation of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide ki jo properties hai, different from carbon and oxygen. Carbon monoxide yahan pe formation ho jati hai. Different from carbon. Its properties are different from carbon as well as from oxygen. That from oxygen. Means, dear students, these are the examples of chemical reaction or also we can say a chemical change. Huh? जहाँ कहीं पे भी आप लोगों को यहाँ पे दिखे कि एक नया substance की formation हो जाती है. Huh? It is a chemical change or that very reaction is known as a chemical reaction. Huh? Shabash. Now, dear students, what are the For example, कहीं पे एक chemical reaction हो जाती है, कहीं पे एक chemical reaction हो जाती है. आप लोग ये कैसे observe कर लोगे, किस तरह से जानोगे कि यहाँ पे reactions तो maximum we are saying that there are the reactions which are occurring in our day-to-day life. For example, carbon reacts with oxygen, carbon dioxide. Carbon reacts with oxygen. Also, there is the formation of carbon monoxide. Nitrogen will react with hydrogen. There is the formation of ammonia. ये हमारे atmosphere में होती रहती है ये reactions. But we are not able to see them. We are not able to see them. Dear students, in our lab, we will be in a position to observe these very changes. Whenever any chemical reaction occurs, जहां कहीं पे भी एक chemical reaction होगी, we are in a position to observe the changes which will occur in the original substance as well as in the new substance which is formed in a chemical reaction. These very observable changes are known as the characteristics of a chemical reaction. Now, dear students, we will discuss characteristics of a chemical reaction. What are the characteristics of a chemical reaction? My dear students, these are the observable changes. Observable changes, those changes which are, we are in a position to observe them. Observable changes in a chemical reaction. In a chemical reaction. Short form is RxN. Represents a reaction. These are the observable changes in a chemical reaction. There are many observable changes in a chemical reaction which we will discuss one by one. First one is formation of a precipitate. PPT. Generally represented by PPT. Second is evolution of gas. Kisi reaction mein gas evolve hota hai. Third one is change in color. Fourth one is change in state. State change ho jati hai. Solid se liquid, liquid se gas se solid. Fifth one and important one is change in temperature. These are the observable changes, dear students, which we are in a position to observe them. And we will say that a chemical reaction is occurring. Chemical reaction has occurred. These are the changes which will We are in a position to observe them. We are in a position to observe them. Main five changes, dear students, are formation of a precipitate, evolution of gas, change in color, change in state, change in temperature. These are the five changes which we are in a position to observe them. Hum un ye panch inhi panch changes ko achhi tarah se observe kar sakte hain, tab hum kahenge ki jo original substance tha uski property jo humne observe ki kya change ho gayi hai, jo new substance tha uski jo property thi wo kya usme kya changes aa gayi hai. Now dear students, we will discuss them one by one. Aap iska screenshot le sakte ho. We are actually discussing the, we have discussed the definition of physical change, chemical reaction. Now characteristics of a chemical reaction, iska aap copy uthaye, aap apni notes banate jaye. आप लोगों को ये बहुत इजी हो जाएगा जब आप लोग अच्छी तरह से नोट्स बनाओगे और स्टेप बाय स्टेप आप लोगों को आप लोग इन नोट्स को देख पाओगे अच्छी तरह से. हां शाबाश. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस दीज वेरी ऑब्जर्वेबल चेंजेस वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट वन इज फॉर्मेशन of precipitate. ब्रैकेट में मैं लिखूंगा, अगर आप एग्जाम में लिखना चाहोगे तो अच्छी तरह से लिखोगे पीपीटी. फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट. माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, देर आर केमिकल रिएक्शन इन विच देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए प्रेसिपिटेट. देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए प्रेसिपिटेट. नाउ the question arises, what is a precipitate? Remember that yahan pe aap logon ko agar exam mein question is tarah se aa sakta hai, what are the characteristics of a chemical reaction, ya is tarah se question aa sakta hai, what are the observable changes which are occurring in a chemical reaction, these are the characteristics of a chemical reaction. Ya alag ye question aa sakta hai, what is a precipitate. Remember that there are some chemical reactions which are accompanied by the formation of a precipitate. Some chemical reactions, CH mein yahan pe likhunga, are accompanied by the formation of a PPT. What is a PPT? A precipitate, main yahan pe likhunga, precipitate is a solid, insoluble substance formed in a chemical reaction. Mind it. मैंने अभी एग्जाम्पल नहीं दे दी, मैंने कहा कि देर आर सर्टन केमिकल रिएक्शन इन विच देर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए प्रेसिपिटेट. अब ये प्रेसिपिटेट क्या है? प्रेसिपिटेट एक सॉलिड इनसॉल्युबल सबस्टेंस है. सॉलिड, इट इज मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज दैट इट इज सॉलिड, एट द सेम टाइम इट इज इनसॉल्युबल इन वाटर. ए प्रेसिपिटेट इज ए सॉलिड इनसॉल्युबल सबस्टेंस फॉर्मड इन ए केमिकल रिएक्शन. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहां पर मैं लिखूंगा, देख लीजिए डियर स्टूडेंट्स, उसके बाद मैं कहूंगा आप लोगों को यहाँ पे नेम ऑफ द यूनिट इज केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड केमिकल इक्वेशंस. केमिकल रिएक्शंस एंड इक्वेशंस, व्हाट इज अ केमिकल रिएक्शन, व्हाट इज अ केमिकल इक्वेशन. यहाँ पे मैं एक्चुअली केमिकल इक्वेशन होती है कि जो केमिकल रिएक्शन में सबस्टेंसेज इन्वॉल्व होते हैं एंड न्यू सबस्टेंसेज आर फॉर्मड. जो सबस्टेंसेस इन्वॉल्व होते हैं या जो न्यू सबस्टेंस की फॉर्मेशन हो जाती है उसकी शॉर्ट हैंड फॉर्म लिखना, उसकी शॉर्ट हैंड फॉर्म होती है केमिकल इक्वेशन. मतलब अगर हमारे पास यहाँ पे कार्बन है, मैं यहाँ पे लिखूंगा कार्बन. कार्बन प्लस ऑक्सीजन गिव्स कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड. अगर मैं यहां लिखूंगा C plus O2 gives CO2. दिस इज केमिकल reaction. This is chemical reaction and this is chemical equation. This is chemical equation. Matlab simple terms mein likh lijiye. Chemical equation, it is a shorthand method of representing a chemical reaction. Shorthand method of representing a chemical reaction in terms of symbols and formulas. In terms of symbols and formulas. Are you getting my point? Bas itna hai. Yahan pe main in terms of symbols and formulas likhunga. Dekh lijiye dear students. Actually, here we are discussing the first characteristic of a chemical reaction. Chemical reaction. Maine yahan pe kaha, there are chemical reactions in which there is the formation of a precipitate. Precipitate kya hoti hai? Ek precipitate solid substance hoti hai, magar it is insoluble in water. Insoluble in water. Abhi maine kaha aap logon ko ki chemical reaction kisse kehte hai? Chemical equation kisse kehte hai? Chemical reaction mein hum completely ek element ka naam likhte hai, ya molecule ka naam likhte hai, lekin chemical equation mein hum uski formula ya symbol, element ki symbol ya compound ki formula likhte hai. Shabaji. Dekh lijiye dear students, first example is when lead nitrate is treated with plus potassium iodide. When lead nitrate is treated with potassium iodide, there is the formation of lead iodide plus potassium nitrate. This is the chemical reaction. मैंने पूरा जो molecule की जो compound की formula, ये जो compound का नाम था मैंने यहाँ पे लिखा. अगर मैं in terms of उसकी formula लिखूँगा, that means chemical equation. This is chemical reaction. मैंने यहाँ पे कहा when lead nitrate is mixed treated with potassium iodide, there is the formation of lead iodide. Yellow precipitate. PPT. Yellow precipitate. A lead iodide, which is solid in nature. इसका main characteristic क्या है? जब lead iodide को water में डाल दिया गया, so it has been found to be insoluble in water. First example, when lead nitrate is treated with, it is mixed with potassium iodide, there is the formation of lead iodide, along with there is the formation of potassium nitrate. But yellow lead iodide has been found to be yellow in color, and also at the same time it is solid in nature. This is, these are colorless solutions. Lead nitrate, potassium iodide, colorless. Lead iodide, yellow in color. Potassium nitrate, colorless. Means, dear students, in case of a formation of a precipitate, there is the formation of solid substance, which has been found to be insoluble in water. This is the precipitate. These are the examples. यहाँ पे मैं इसकी formula chemical. This is chemical reaction. Now इसकी formula मैं लिखूँगा. Lead nitrate Pb NO3 whole twice plus potassium iodide Ki. Two times Ki. यहाँ पे मैं लिखूँगा directly Pbi. Plus KNO3. It is two times PbI2 plus KNO3. It is two times. Or ye are this yellow PPT. PPT, यहाँ पे S solid, yellow PPT, yellow precipitate. Precipitate is a solid substance which has been found to be insoluble in water. This is its first example. Second example, मेरा एक और लेक्चर यहां पे विद रिस्पेक्ट टू केमिकल फार्मूलाज आने वाला है. आप लोगों ने 9th में भी इसका थोड़ा बहुत कांसेप्ट होगा. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट वेरी लेक्चर यू विल बी इन अ पुश. वहां पे मैं पूरा एक्सप्लेन कर लूंगा कि किस तरह से आप किसी भी कंपाउंड की मॉलिक्यूलर फार्मूला लिख सकते हो. दूसरी एग्जांपल फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट व्हेन बैरियम क्लोराइड is treated with sodium sulfate. There has been found there is the formation of a precipitate, white precipitate of barium sulfate. Plus there is the, this is yellow white, white PPT plus sodium chloride. This is an example of a precipitate formation of a precipitate when barium chloride is treated with sodium sulfate. There is a formation of barium sulfate plus sodium chloride. This is chemical reaction. Now, its chemical equation BaCl2 plus Na2SO4 is sodium sulfate. There is the formation of BaSO4 barium sulfate plus 2 times NaCl. This is its chemical equation. Shorthand method. We write it in the form of symbols and formulas. Now, this is the chemical reaction. White precipitate, solid in nature. This is solid in nature. White precipitate. And barium sulfate is also insoluble in water. It is also insoluble in water. Now, dear students, these are the examples of फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए प्रेसिपिटेट. किस तरह से आप इसको याद रखोगे डियर स्टूडेंट्स. फर्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए प्रेसिपिटेट. व्हाट इज अ प्रेसिपिटेट? अ प्रेसिपिटेट इज अ सॉलिड सब्सटेंस व्हिच इज इनसॉल्युबल इन वाटर. इट इज फॉर्मड ड्यूरिंग अ केमिकल रिएक्शन व्हेन टू एलिमेंट्स व्हेन ओरिजिनल एलिमेंट्स रिएक्ट. There is the formation of new substances with new properties. Yahan pe original substances barium chloride, sodium sulfate. Yahan pe barium sulfate aur sodium chloride ki formation ho gayi. Now, second characteristic is evolution of gas. अब आप लोगों को ये भी थोड़ा बहुत समझ आ गया होगा कि chemical reaction किसे कहते हैं और chemical equation में हम शॉर्ट हैंड मेथड लेते हैं सिंपल विद द हेल्प ऑफ सिंबल्स एंड फार्मूलाज. सेकंड वन इज इवॉल्वेशन ऑफ गैस. It has been found that some chemical reactions, there are certain chemical reactions which are accompanied by evolution of gas. For example, some chemical reaction, आप इतना लिख सकते हो, खुद लिख लीजिए, जिस तरह से मैंने formation of precipitate में कहा, some chemical reactions are accompanied by the formation of a precipitate. After that, मैंने explain किया precipitate किसे कहते हैं. यहाँ पे आप खुद लिख सकते हो, या directly लिख सकते हो, there are chemical reactions in which there is evolution of gas. For example, when zinc has been found to when reaction of zinc takes place with sulfuric acid, there is the formation of zinc sulfate plus hydrogen gas. This is chemical reaction. It is chemical equation. Zinc solid plus H2SO4. There is the formation of ZnSO4 plus H2 gas. देख लीजिए बेटा, मैंने एरो ऊपर की तरह दिखाया. It indicates us these very gases escape through in the atmosphere. These very gases, always the gases, they are escaping in the atmosphere. Now, this is the example of a chemical reaction in which there is the evolution of hydrogen gas. In this very case, hydrogen gas. This is its chemical reaction. This is its chemical equation. Chemical equation mein hum kya karte hain? We are writing the original as well as the new substances. These are the original substances, these are the new substances in terms of symbols and formulas. This is the symbol of zinc, this is the formula of H2SO4, that is aqueous. Aqueous ka matlab hai, we are taking H2SO4 in water. This is also aqueous and this is gas. Hydrogen gas ki formation ho gayi that escapes into the atmosphere. Aur ek example yahan pe hai, regarding the evolution of evolution of gas, CaCO3, calcium carbonate. Calcium carbonate, when we heat calcium carbonate, it is solid in nature. When we heat calcium carbonate, there is the formation of CaO. This is also solid in nature, but there is the formation of hydrogen gas, carbon dioxide gas. This is calcium carbonate. This is calcium oxide and this is carbon dioxide. अब मैंने directly आपको chemical equation पहले दिखाई, याद कर देख लीजिए बेटा कि actually calcium carbonate, calcium gives calcium oxide when we are heating calcium carbonate, and also there is the formation of a gas, carbon dioxide. This is gas, G, that escapes into the atmosphere. This is also the example of a reaction in which there is the evolution of a gas, whether it may be carbon dioxide gas, whether it may be hydrogen gas, yeah, any other gas. These are the examples of evolution of gas. Now यहाँ पे आप खुद लिख सकते हो, एक या अगर एग्जाम में आ गया तो एक ज्यादा से ज्यादा एक एग्जाम्पल लिख लीजिए, दिस वेरी एग्जाम्पल, और ऊपर आप लिख सकते हो कि देयर आर द केमिकल रिएक्शंस इन व्हिच देयर इज द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ गैस. नाउ थर्ड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज चेंज इन कलर. उसी तरह से देयर आर केमिकल रिएक्शंस इन विच देयर इज ए चेंज इन कलर. खुद लिख लीजिए, देयर आर केमिकल रिएक्शंस इन विच देयर इज चेंज इन कलर. मैं यहां पे एग्जांपल दे दूंगा. फॉर एग्जांपल डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आप लोगों ने देखा होगा आयरन, व्हेन आयरन FeS रिएक्ट्स विद O2 plus water, देयर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ Fe2O3 X times water. This is iron. Iron की symbol S है. Oxygen की O2 gaseous, water liquid. There is the formation of Fe2O3. This is known as rust. Or in other words, we can see it is the rusting of iron. X times water means water of crystallization. उसके साथ है water. Now, dear students, there are the chemical reactions in which there is change in color. Iron is grayish, black in color. Grayish, black in color. But rust is reddish, brown in color. It is reddish, brown in color. That means there is the change in color from original substances to the new substances. Rust ki formula ye hoti hai. Aur ek yahan pe dekh lijiye, dear students. Aur ek यहाँ पे मैं आप लोगों को एग्जांपल देता हूँ. फॉर एग्जांपल अभी मैंने यहाँ पे कहा कि व्हेन लेड नाइट्रेट रिएक्ट्स विद पोटेशियम आयोडाइड, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेट में लेड नाइट्रेट रिएक्ट्स विद पोटेशियम आयोडाइड. यहाँ पे मैंने कहा PbNO3 होल ट्वाइस रिएक्ट्स विद Ki, देयर इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ डियर स्टूडेंट्स PbI2 plus पोटेशियम नाइट्रेट. दिस इज टू टाइम्स. यहां पे मैंने कहा दिस इज आल्सो कलरलेस, बट दिस इज कलर, येल्लो इन कलर. दिस इज आल्सो कलरलेस. माइंड इट, यहां आप डायरेक्टली लिख सकते हो इसका नाम लेड नाइट्रेट प्लस पोटेशियम आयोडाइड गिव्स लेड आयोडाइड प्लस पोटेशियम नाइट्रेट. नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स,
These are the examples of change in color. There are some chemical reactions in which there is change in color. Examples yaad rakh lijiye, when the rusting of iron takes place, iron reacts with oxygen and carbon water, and there is the formation of rust, which is reddish brown in color. Also, there is another example. Lead nitrate reacts with potassium iodide. There is the formation of potassium yellow precipitate of potassium iodide. Yeah. Also, there will be the formation of a white precipitate when barium chloride reacts with sodium sulfate. There is the formation of white precipitate of barium sulfate. Jo humne formation of precipitate mein example de di. Now, this is change in color. There are some chemical reactions in which there is change in color. Exam mein aa jayega. Ek example zyada se zyada de dijiye. Fourth one is change in state. Change in state. Wahi examples mein dohraunga taaki aap logon ko samajh aa jayega. Pyare bachcho, for example, ya aur ek example yahan pe hai, solid wax. When it burns, when we are burning solid wax, candle jise hum kehte hain, candle. When it burns, there is the formation of carbon dioxide, gas plus water. Water vapors, dekh lijiye aap. Water vapors, carbon dioxide and water vapors, which are gaseous in nature, Or ek example, dear students, petrol. Ye jo ye candle hoti hai, it is solid in nature, hai na? Change in state has taken, there is the change in state from solid to gas, from solid to, when we are burning a candle, there is the formation of carbon dioxide and water vapors, which are gaseous in nature, and candle in turn is solid. Petrol kya hota hai? Beta, it is liquid. When it burns, there is the formation of carbon dioxide plus water vapors. There is the formation of carbon dioxide plus water vapors. Both are gases. This is the example. These are the examples of change in state. Yeah, jitni bhi maine example de di. Wahan pe bhi change in state ho gai. Zinc plus sulfuric acid. Zinc, it is solid in nature, and there is the formation, when it reacts with sulfuric acid, liquid in nature, there is the formation of zinc sulfate, liquid in nature, and hydrogen gas has evolved. Ek mein reactant mein state alag thi, product mein alag state thi. Solid, liquid or gas. These are the examples of change in state. Now change in temperature. Fifth one is change in temperature. Now, dear students, there are some reactions in which there is rise or fall in temperature. There are certain reactions in which there is rise or temperature badh jata hai ya kam ho jata hai. Remember that those reactions in which there is rise in temperature, yeah, are those processes in which there is rise in temperature, are those in which heat energy is evolved. Mind. Aap is tarah se likh sakte ho, those processes in which there is rise in temperature are those, yahan pe likh lijiye, are those in which heat energy is evolved. Those reactions in which heat energy is evolved are known as exothermic reactions. are known as exothermic reactions. Those reactions are, in other words, agar aap logon ko koi kahe what are exothermic reactions, those reactions in which there is rise in temperature are what we can say there is heat energy is evolved. In case of exothermic reactions, heat energy is evolved. Heat energy is, or in other words, we can say there is the rise in temperature. For example, dekh lijiye, mere paas ek beaker hai. Mere paas ek beaker hai. Samjh lijiye, dear students. Beaker mein mere paas CaO hai. CaO, that is calcium oxide. It is also known as lime. Quick lime se kehte hain. जब मैंने इसमें वाटर डाल दिया, जब मैंने इसमें वाटर डाल दिया, there is the formation of when CaO plus H2O reacts with CaO solid, H2O liquid reacts with calcium oxide reacts with water. There is the formation of CaOH whole twice. This is known as calcium hydroxide. Or it is known as, its common name is slaker lime. Slaker lime. Dekh lijiye, dear students. Main kya keh raha hoon? Ki actually, we are discussing the fifth characteristic of chemical reactions. Change in temperature. There are chemical reactions in which there is a rise in temperature. For example, maine calcium oxide ko water ke saath mix kiya, lime ko water ke saath mix kiya. Jab maine mix kiya, main beaker pe, jab maine bottom of beaker pe haath lagaya, I have found it to be warm. Pehle jab na calcium oxide sirf beaker mein tha, maine beaker ko touch kiya to warm nahi tha. Jab maine usme pani dal diya, wahan pe reaction ho gayi, calcium hydroxide ki formation ho gayi, aur wahan pe jab maine dekh liya beaker ki tar, beaker pe haath lagaya to I found it to be means there is rise in temperature. There is jab ye warm tha to there is evolution, there is heat energy is evolved. Heat energy is those reactions in which heat energy is evolved, which are found to be warm in nature after the reaction takes place. These are known as exothermic reactions. Calcium oxide reacts with water. This main example, there is the formation of calcium hydroxide and heat energy is evolved. Aur ek reaction yahan pe hai jo maine abhi dikhai, evolution of gas mein. Zinc plus sulfuric acid, when zinc reacts with sulfuric acid, zinc sulfate ki formation ho jati hai, hydrogen gas evolve hota hai, lekin uske saath saath heat energy is evolved. Wahan pe bhi dekha gaya hai, agar wo beaker mein hogi wo reaction ya kisi flask mein hogi, yahan pe maine dikhaya beaker mein, to dear students, us beaker ko ya us instrument ko jahan pe wo reaction hoti hai, it has been found to be warm. Now change in temperature. First one is, there are certain reactions in which there is rise in or fall in temperature. Those reactions in which there is rise in temperature are those in which heat energy is evolved. Itna is tarah se aap likh sakte ho. Those reactions in which there is rise in temperature are those in which heat energy is evolved. These are exothermic reactions. Exothermic reaction ki bhi yahan pe definition, characteristic of chemical reaction bhi yahan pe clear ho gaya ki exothermic reaction kisse kehte hain. Iske baad hamara jo लेक्चर होगा बैलेंसिंग, उसके बाद टाइप्स ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन, वहां पे उसके फिर से हम एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शन का कांसेप्ट वहां पे दे देंगे अच्छी तरह से. लेकिन यहां पे याद रख लीजिए कि एक्सोथर्मिक रिएक्शंस उन्हीं रिएक्शंस को कहा जाता है जिनमें हीट एनर्जी इवॉल्व होती है. ये एक एग्जांपल है, दिस इज एन व्हेन कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड रिएक्ट्स विद वाटर, कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड इज फॉर्मड. दिस इज कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड CaO, कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड. कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड रिएक्ट्स विद वाटर. कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड का कॉमन नेम क्विक लाइम भी होता है. क्विक, ये चीजें नोट कीजिए, क्विक लाइम. एंड कैल्शियम हाइड्रोक्साइड स्लैकर लाइम. नाउ चेंज इन टेम्परेचर का, फॉर एग्जांपल दिस वाज राइज, नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द फॉल. और एक रिएक्शन यहां पे मैं लिखूंगा, Those reactions in which there is fall, abhi to maine likha rise, fall in temperature
TMP are those in which heat energy is absorbed. Bekleyin, ben yazacağım. Endothermic reactions. इसका मतलब है कि डियर स्टूडेंट्स वो रिएक्शन इज जहां पे टेंपरेचर फॉल हो जाएगा उन रिएक्शंस में हीट एनर्जी एब्जॉर्ब होती है उन रिएक्शंस में जिनमें राइज हो जाएगा उनमें हीट एनर्जी इवॉल्व होती है नाउ यहां पे मैं एग्जांपल दे दूंगा देख लीजिए नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स इट हैज बीन फाउंड दैट इफ बेरियम हाइड्रोक्साइड BaH2 is treated with NH4Cl, NH4 ammonium chloride. When barium hydroxide has been found to be treated with ammonium chloride, yahan pe main likhunga barium hydroxide, yahan pe barium hydroxide plus ammonium chloride. There is the formation of barium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide. समझ दीजिए देख दीजिए बेटा बैरियम हाइड्रोक्साइड की फार्मूला BaOH होल टूवाइस अमोनियम क्लोराइड की NH4Cl बैरियम क्लोराइड की BaCl2 अमोनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड की NH4OH NH4OH देख लीजिए नाउ Actually here, dear students, we are discussing Pauling temperature. When this very reaction occurred in a beaker, जब ये reaction एक beaker में हो गई, वहाँ पे देखा गया, there is fall. मतलब जब मैंने beaker को touch किया, it has been found to be cool. Huh? We found the beaker to be cold. वहाँ पे Pauling temperature. वहाँ पे Pauling temperature. In the first case, we found the beaker to be hot. We found the beaker to be warm. We found the beaker to be warm. Now, means, यहाँ पे heat energy absorb हो गई है. Heat energy has been absorbed. Heat energy has been found to be absorbed. Huh? Now, अच्छी तरह से आप देख लीजिए. एक example है. Barium hydroxide reacts with ammonium chloride. There is a formation of barium chloride plus ammonium hydroxide. Barium hydroxide की ये formula. Ammonium chloride की ये formula. Barium chloride की BaCl2. Ammonium hydroxide की NH4OH. Now, there are certain reactions in which there is heat energy is absorbed or there is fall in temperature. This is the characteristic of a chemical reaction. This is the characteristic of a chemical reaction with respect to change in temperature. Matlab, there are the reactions in which there is rise or fall in temperature. Jin mein rise hoga, exothermic in nature. Jin mein fall hoga, endothermic in nature. Rise hoga, energy is evolved, fall hoga, energy is absorbed. This is the characteristic of a chemical reaction. Ye kis tarah se hame pata chal jayega? Jis instrument mein wo reaction hogi, hum usko touch kar lenge. Agar rise hoga to exothermic, cold hoga to endothermic. Endothermic ka matlab absorb heat energy absorb hogi. That means dear students, mind it. These are the characteristics of a chemical reaction. Aap kis tarah se observe kar sakte ho ki ek chemical reaction ho gayi hai. There are plenty of reactions occurring in our day-to-day life. For example, digestion. Breakdown of complex molecules into simpler ones. For example, respiration. Breakdown of glucose into carbon dioxide and water. For example, photosynthesis. Preparation of glucose from carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll, and sunlight. These are the examples of the chemical reactions. Either in chemical reaction mein ek se zyada changes ho jayenge. Change in color bhi ho sakta hai. Change in state bhi ho sakta hai. Formation of precipitate bhi ho sakti hai, change in temperature bhi ho sakta hai, are you getting my point? Ya evaluation of gas bhi ho sakta hai, ek hi reaction mein 2-3 changes back vakar ho sakti hai, are you getting my point? That means in our day-to-day life, we are
surrounded by chemical reactions which are occurring around us, Thus, we have completed that topic, chemical reactions and its characteristics. And it is after that I will here discuss, after this very topic, we will discuss here how to balance a chemical reaction. There are mainly two methods. Other than hit and trial method, yahan pe main hit and trial method nahi dikhaunga. Thus, my dear students, tab tak ke liye, all the very best.